Hello and welcome to our stream tonight, ladies and gentlemen and gorgeous gamers. I am Atwas and I'm here with my wonderful casting partner, Mario. Say hi.
Hello!
And tonight it is Silver Savages versus Memento Mori on CP underscore Steel. The second time the map is being played this season, and as we're heading into the playoffs, we're going to be seeing some hot action going on. Whew! I am so ready for it. And as we wait to get started here, anything you want to say about the map, about the teams? Like, what's going on?
What is this? This is the second week that this map's being played. Are we starting? That was really quick. Did they go live? Okay, well, anyway, real quick, before we start during the setup, don't forget, guys, that there are t-shirts available for purchase underneath the stream. The money goes towards EVL and the casters of which you buy them for. There is a Flatline shirt, a Dashner shirt, a Deer shirt, and at the bottom there is an Atwas shirt, all available for purchase, so make sure you guys check them out real quick. They're really nice, and we still have a few seconds. Let's go down and go through the rosters. I'll start with the Silver Savages. We got Godwash on Scout, we have Jaxter on Soldier, we have Lazy on Pyro, Invader is on Demoman, we have Treelon on Heavy, Angry Officer is on Engineer, Skeez is on Medic, Feral Apper on Sniper, and Loblate is on Spy.
And on Memento Mori, we have Scythe on Scout, Doll on Soldier, Joseph on Pyro, Giraffe on Demo, Eerie Person playing Heavy, Scratchy on NG, Apple on Medic, Bagel on Sniper, and Deftrolled or Joe on Spy.
Yeah, quick start caught me off guard. Usually it doesn't take that.
Right?
It takes a lot longer than that. That might be a new record. Anyway, we have the Memento Mori team starting off on the defense. We have the Silver Savages are attacking. We have a light defense coming out of the MM on A, but it looks like the Silver Savages are going to completely clean them up. And Skeez and the SS team are going to cap A completely for free.
Absolutely. Worth noting, Giraffe actually went down extremely early there to a nice snipe from Pharaoh Affer. So, you know, that's pretty significant not being able to defend with a demo. We do have a level 3 in play. It looks like Joseph is going to be spy checking a whole lot and Bagels over here up on this cheeky ledge. And we do have an E play going on right here, so we see a lot of rotation out of that team. And we're going to see Palovly trying to sneak in as most of the other team rolls out, trying to get some intel going on. And it looks like people are being scared off of E at this moment, but that is a lot of blue gamers. Fairhaver is synced up, he's looking in that connector, looking for a pick. Palovly already went down, and so did another gamer as well. He's going to be getting on really quick. And here we go, more pressure on E. There's a lot of casualty from the blue team coming on here, but hey, it's good to keep that pressure on and keep it on.
Yeah, it looked like one of those E fakes that you do quite a while, but Silver Savages rotated their flank and their sniper over there. Right now we have, who is that? Pharaoh Apper. He's over on the respawn side, trying to shoot what he can coming through the door, but Godwash gets about 50% of that cap on the E point, so a lot of pressure coming from him, but we do have the Silver Savages squad rotating through their spawn over to B, and the combo of MM is going to get caught up, and we have the angry.
Oh my
Hello,
God.
Is my mic working? Sorry.
Alright, as that happened, that was actually a really sick, nasty flare pick from Joseph onto the enemy medic, and so that's gonna be a really nice push onto B. A lot of stuff going on there, and it does like, here we go, counter Uber coming out, Giraffe in the lead over there, Treylon does go down, and they manage to block B before Silver Savages gets that cap. Invader is still in play, he gets taken out, Bagel gets stabbed by Palovly in the sort of carnage right there, and here we go, Joseph's coming in there, Medic caught out alone, Skeez trying to get that Surf out of there, but absolutely not, says the red team scout, and that'll be Memento Mori. Giving a pretty nice defense right there, as it looks like Silver Savages is gonna have to regroup. Of course, they have that spawn advantage. But, you know, I'm waiting to see something happening. A sentry is getting set up. He was on level 3s, he's now on mini sentries that will be scratchy. And so we're gonna see a much easier push coming in here, and hopefully Memento Mori doesn't bleed too much.
Hey, sorry about that. I knocked my mic out of my USB, but I'm back right now. We have a Jirati come out, actually. And Jaxter and Invader are gonna get cleaned up off those mini crits. And Silver Savages looks like they really want to pressure this B point, but forward defense from the NM squad and Giraffe's just overall pressure from his demo man experience are just crushing them right now. And I was expecting Silver Savages to just take this game, but looks like it's going to be a nice game with Giraffe's however much Highlander experience. And he just carries this team, like he knows what he's doing. He's played this map a lot, and he's probably the one calling all the shots in this team. But Pharaoh are going to get a nice pick onto Eerie Person, so he's going to go down. That's a weak defense for the MM team. And Silver Savages looks like they want to rotate over to E. They have a lot of pressure over there. And Skeez is going to pop his Uber, trying to do what they can, but they're looking into the eyes of a Pyro over on that connector. Geosis doing a good job shutting down that E-push.
I don't know about that. We do have a lot of presence from Silver Savages on that E-point, and the Uber did get popped. Pharaoh Afra does get taken down as well. Sniper isn't as strong on this map as it is on other maps. Lazy doing a nice job of getting some denial out here, and there is quite a bit of Jurati thrown out, but it looks like Trillin and Skeez will be fairly safe right here as Eerie Person does get taken down, so that's a pretty good pick without a heavy weapons guy in the way. The Uber did get popped off by Apple, but they're going to have to retreat, and it looks like with frags being chased back and forth here, and Trillin and Skeez still sort of camping that secondary spawn entrance, we're going to see a really nice strong E-push.
Trillin is just holding down the shutter with his minigun. He's just destroying anything that tries to peek right now, but Giraffe is pressuring him out with those stickies, just getting infinite amounts from that resupply locker, but Godwash is putting so much time on that point that the MM team can't, like, defend. And Trillin is just going huge with his minigun right now, but looks like he's going to get pressured out. Not giving up, he actually picks up Scratchy, and he has his life. And Skeez is going to pop his Uber on that spawn door. There's absolutely nothing that the MM team can do. We do have Apple. He is alive. I don't see his Uber charge. Looks like my HUD might be broken, but he does pop his Uber right onto the point. The point is almost capped. Godwash is tapping his toes onto the point. He is going to cap that with a 5-minute E time. Courtesy of Lazy and Godwash on that point.
Yowza. Shoutouts to Lazy running that detonator so he can jump onto the point and put a lot of pressure on there, reflect a lot of spam, keep his scout alive. That was pretty good.
Yeah,
Steel is... Go ahead.
5 minutes is... 5 minutes is... It's okay. I've seen significantly faster, like high platinum teams usually see between 3.5 to 4 minutes, so 5 minutes is definitely a very, very good time, but it's also easily beatable, so MM is going to have to do a strong defense here. The Silver Savages are going to have to do a strong defense here because it is beatable, and MM just needs to get their gear and get ready and attack the points.
Mission begins in 10 seconds. Do you think they're going to go for an E-push right away or not?
No. I'm going with an Ape strat, the ABE strat,
yeah.
Or maybe we're going to see it on Realm of World, which is just capping every point. Yeah, that's what it's called. Don't wear it out.
Oh my god, Coast to Coast. Now I have that Daft Punk song stuck in my head. Thanks a lot. We're not seeing too much of defense on A right now, so it looks like it's going to be an easy cab over here for Memento Mori. Apple is at 100%. Deathroll did go down. That is Joe, actually, did go down. And so we're going to be seeing a bit of an offense being mounted up here. We do have a Wrangled level 3 courtesy angry officer over here, and Pharaoh Ivor is just ready to do some action right here, and there, once more, Joe gets taken down by Invader. And so here we are, sticky trap above the entrance, and throwing out some stickies, just trying to get a little bit of a handhold or a foothold or an anything hold over onto B. I'm not seeing too much pressure going towards, but it looks like Jaxter's over here trying to defend alone, and Scratchy actually gets taken down, so, you know, here we go, Uber exchange going down, Giraffe versus Invader, the battle of the demos, not too many frags being exchanged here, Joe getting mowed out of the air by Trillin, who's trying to go in for that pick, and managed to get the sap, but it's not going to happen too much, and Trillin's actually in a pretty good position up here, sort of cutting off any sort of flanking or jumping up above that point.
Good coordination between Paladli and F getting the engineer and sapping the gun, but I don't know if his sapper went on. Is there a power, or I'm sorry, is there a homewrecker? The gun didn't go down, so that is still a level 3 up for the Silver Savages. But I really, really like this defense. This is one of my favorite defenses that they have set up. It's a super aggro defense on B. But the only way that this works is if your combo is very, very coordinated and they know when to rotate to E. But we do have the MM squad trying to push over to E. They're in the the DA connector, trying to do what they can, and, who is a giraffe, trying to put as many stickies as he can under that front spot. But Skeez is gonna go ahead and pop his Uber. Bagel goes down, to Death Troll, and we had a crater over there. I'm not sure who that was, but I heard it.
That was Invader. Shout out to Invader falling into the pit right here. And it looks like Trill Allen is going to hold up, meet up with his medic, and get people off of their shutter. And so while Memento Mori is trying to get a lot more stuff going on here, it looks like Skeez is going to pop his Uber and chase them all the way out. And ooh, there's a lot of frags going away of Silver Savages. Lovely. Fairweather gets a nice headshot onto Scratchy right there. And it's just a lot of carnage going on here. Memento Mori has a lot of gamers down right now. And oh, please, Joe, I want it. No, he got caught out. Didn't quite get it. Almost made it happen.
I was looking for a deer right there, man. He got about two swipes onto him. Only a few more and he would have been down, but we have Bagel trying to peek up on this upper area. He's trying to do what he can, but Oferioff is going to clean him up with a nice shot. We have a nice, good bomb come in from, who is the soldier on MM? He's aliased right now.
That would be Doll.
Doll, yeah, he bombed in, but he didn't get anything very good. Giraffe and the Memento Mori squad are going to go cap B. And Silver Savage is playing very smart. They're going to back up into the connector. We have Pharaoh Effers shooting down this connector right now. Giraffe going to be the first one in. What's he going to get? Is he going to get anything? No, he's going to back up with his life. Invader going to pick up a nice frag onto Geosis. They are holding a little bit aggro, but Ski is going to go ahead and pop his Uber onto Invader. Invader just destroying everything with Jaxter by his side. Demoman 2.0, the soldier. Very, very good on this map. Don't forget about the soldier, because he will kill you.
Bagel Doll and Scratchy do go down in that Uber as the rest of Silver Savages back up. It was actually pretty smart of them to pop their Uber. They know they can probably hold this point for. There's a minute left on the clock. They have a level 3 outside that respawn. I don't really think there's any way for Memento Mori to pull this off unless they get really, really coordinated here and they get some ridiculous picks. But just in terms of positioning, I'm not really seeing that happen right now, even if they have B capped. But here we are. They are sort of regrouping, trying to get that happen, trying to get into that connector, but there's just so much spam being laid out. Mind Vader Lazy gets a sick reflect onto Doll. That was a really nice frag there. And Skeez is, you know, his toes have been pretty clean, and not to mention, he also has Uber Charge. He's gonna get really aggressive with his team. Invader actually goes down, Bagel getting a really nice headshot off of him. I don't see how this is happening. There are 23 seconds left on the clock. There is just nasty stuff going on. Skeez pops his Uber Charge. The enemy Pyro did try to do a lot right there, but I don't think that's gonna happen as we approach 10 seconds and nobody is really alive or in position to contest this point.
I was doing a little bit of testing on this map, and I think the maximum that you can cap B point is I think it's 30 seconds or 25 seconds, but you need a times 12 or 14 on the point, literally every class with Pain Train. So I mean, I've done it. It is possible to cap that fast, but it's highly, highly unlikely. Usually it's an average about 45 seconds. If you cap a couple of the extra points, I think if you cap D, it slightly increases it to maybe about 40 seconds. I could be wrong on that, but it does increase it just a little bit. So you need about a minute to cap this point overall. And if you don't have people or time on the point before that, there's really no coming back.
Exactly. And with that sentry coming out with all those gamers on point with that Uber, I don't really think there's anything left to do. And I feel like it's a game sort of between Invader and Giraffe right about now, just because how ridiculous Demo is on this map. As well as I've been seeing Jaxter and, Doll doing a lot of work as well. Both of them are running, I believe it was Conjurer, giving their teams a little bit of an extra boost.
I think I saw a black box in there, too.
Yeah, that would be Jaxter on the black box.
I'm taking a look at these stats, and oh my god, the Memento squad, 73 frags to the 47 of the Silver Savages, that's backwards. Silver Savages, 73 frags to the MM's 47. So there is a humongous frag difference right now, and it's definitely showing. The medics are about equal. Skeez died one less time. But overall, just the deaths on the Silver Savages squad probably led them to that loss.
Yeah,
the
definitely.
Loss of that round.
Yeah, shoutouts to Invader for doing a lot of fragging, that's for sure. And although we did mention that this isn't necessarily a super sniper heavy map, Ferraffer is holding his own in terms of this and going on.
Yeah, and Godwash. Shoutouts to Godwash. Not only did he cap that point almost single-handedly,
mm-hmm.
he also he tied with Invader for 13 frags in the server, so that's insane. Like, not only do you cap E by tiptoeing, hopping on and off the point, you also frag. So that is a huge, huge personal play from Godwash. Definitely coming out and doing a lot of work for Silver Savages.
Most definitely. And actually, I have a little bit of insider information. I have heard that Memento Mori hasn't really been able to scrim this map all that much, only picking up, one scrim in the past week? So that's not working out too well for them. All right.
Yeah, it's definitely showing, too.
Mm-hmm. I believe we're going to get ready to go soon. And so, yo, just shoutouts once more. We do have some pretty sick-looking merch that you can put on your body, directly supports your caster, your producer, helps us give you a show to watch, and especially with playoffs coming up, it would be really nice to just throw out some support, help us keep doing the thing that we love for the thing that you love, which is hopefully Team Fortress 2. Hopefully. Otherwise, you probably wouldn't be here. And here we go. It looks like Memento Mori will be on the attack at first this round, and so they'll be looking once more into the face of a pretty savage, if I may say, Silver Savage's defense right here.
Ah.
I'm sorry, that was so bad.
We have, who is that? We got Skies and Invader. They're on B shooting some crit stickies into the spawn. I don't even know where he shot those. I don't know, he shot them somewhere, but they're on the ground. We have a level 3, very, very defensive over on the B side. And actually, I'm sorry, he was shooting crit stickies on A, but yeah. We have Angry Officer, he does pick up his gun. So he is moving it to the very, very aggressive spot on B. I love this setup, and this was one of my favorite things to do when I played Engineer. And it works so well when you have a team that is able to coordinate. But we are going to start the round, and we have MM just throwing their flank over onto this B side, trying to cap it for as fast as they can and for as free as they can, and see if they can get any frags. Ferraffer is actually going to go down to Giraffe, so that is a pretty, pretty big pick. No sniper on B, so the Silver Savages, MM squad definitely needs to pick it up into high gear and get over to this B point with the snipers down, but it doesn't look like they're going to get in time because he is back up and alive. But we have, who is that? We got the Bagel, he's trying to peek. He gets a pick on his ski! Oh, that is a drop onto B! Oh my god! that was unexpected. We have Apple coming into B. He is going to pop his Uber. He's flashing very, very fast. His Uber is actually over. That was a very, very quick Uber. He did flash a lot of people, but they are going to get this B cap almost relatively for free with some huge picks.
Yeah, that was really decisive. Invader being just picked out of the air by there by Eerie Person was really nice as well. And so finally, maybe we'll see some A to B to E action, as people are getting through the connector here, getting into position. Joseph and Giraffe sort of gaining a little bit of ground, trying to meet up with people. And it looks like the combo's actually pushing in towards C right now, and Giraffe is in position to sort of throw out some stickies, hold this off. Godwash gets taken down in sort of a collateral type deal right there. And yo, Apple is approaching Ubercharge. Skies is pretty far behind on that front. So they can get C for sure, but I want to see them be able to push this into D.
Yeah, the only one problem about going into D is you have to run in between two of the red team spawns, aka Death Hallway. As you should or do not know, it is probably one of the most dangerous locations to go through in the game, but a Shaxer blowing the conch, just he's gonna get caught out and he is just dead. That was Doll, not Jaxer, but Silver Savage is dropping so many players right now. Their entire four people that are up are over defending D, and I think that Memento Mori notices that, and they're just going to muscle their way all the way over straight to E. They're going to completely ignore the D cap, and they have their combo set up in the upper area where the defending engineer usually builds, and this is such a great location to hold your combo. You have very good high ground advantage, and it's just overall generally good, but we have the Skeez Uber coming in, and the Memento Mori is going to retaliate onto that Heavy, just pressuring out the defending side, and I don't think Giraffe's going to be able to get through here.
Oh man, that was a pretty nice jump, Lazy, onto the point. Skeez gets taken down by Joe, Traylon gets taken down by Joe, that was a really nice double stab going on there. Jaxter cleans up Scratchy, but that is definitely going on. It looks like Memento Mori will have to go back and try to re-push, although Joe right there sort of really saved that momentum, and it looks like Joseph and the rest of his combo is going to be going in through here. Shoutouts to, I believe it is Giraffe using the Iron Bomber? One of the demos is. Jaxter is on a nice 5-kill streak going in. He's been all over this map, and I'm sure the black box really helps with that. As I say that, it does look like Angry Officer. He does have a level 2 setup over point, so that'll definitely prevent any scouts, any squishy classes from sort of tiptoeing their way onto said point once more. He gets taken down, however, by Joe, who wasn't having a really great first half, but it looks like he's having a better second half for sure, as we have a lot of frags being exchanged over here in this hallway area. Apple's going in with his team. Oh, Palovly trying to run and get something happen. Yeah, it didn't quite work out. He tried though, A plus for effort, as we do have people on the point, and by people, I mean pretty much the entire Memento Mori combo, and they're trying to get in there. Joseph is doing his best to reflect some stuff over there. Invader gets taken down, so that's really good. Giraffe actually takes down Palovly as well, and so Memento Mori can just sort of keep some pressure on here. Apple does have Uber. Skeez doesn't have it. Yes, gets it right there, and it looks like they are instead rotating to D to get a little bit more time for... Oh, as I say that, here we go. Both Ubers popped out on D. Looks like the only frag being picked up was Lazy, who was caught out to begin with, and Traylon sort of out here alone, doing a good job of avoiding a lot of damage from Giraffe, as D is for sure going to get capped, and it looks like Memento Mori is going to take control of this hallway over here.
Yeah, the flank of Jaxter, he's on like a 9-kill streak right now, but he's just doing a lot of work, and he's cleaning up all those other players that are just running around. And the Memento Mori squad is going to pick up this decap, which is going to definitely affect the spawns of the Silver Savages, making them run all the way around the map in order to get to the middle point of E, which you overall have to capture to win. But Skeez and the Silver Savages are dropping so many players. Actually, Skeez is going to go down to Giraffe. Giraffe also picks up Invader. So right now, the only part of the combo is up is Traylon. He's just shooting as many minigun bullets as he can, but ooh, Pharaoh are getting a nice pick onto Giraffe, so that's a lot of spam down for the MM team. And we have Traylon, he's just underneath right here, trying to do what he can, but ooh, do we have a pause?
We do have a pause.
I love pauses.
Do you now? I'm watching Palovly getting perpetually burned to death in the air by Joseph right here as Apple rotates to him. Apple's up. Apple has 88%. I want to see a collapse onto point right here. It does look like Memento Mori is in a pretty good position right here. IF is ready to contest a little bit. There are only a few people. Here we go. Unpaused. Only 4 people up on Silver Savages. Spy is on point. That is Joe. He's going to be capping along with Doll, Syath, and Eerie Person. That's going to be a x5 on the point. Apple joins them. So does their Pyre. I don't think there's going to be a pretty good way for Silver Savages to get in here, but they're going to try. Eerie Person actually doing a good thing, watching that hallway right there as they have a x7 on point. And there's no way. It has to be the Memento Mori play, unless there's some sort of ridiculous play out. Just like Joe picked up a nice stab onto Skeez, and so despite the carnage and people jumping around on point, oh my god, Godwash trying to do the unthinkable, but doesn't quite happen. He finally gets taken down. He was dancing around on that point as long as he could, and that is a, 5-minute, 50-second time.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that is pretty good.
There was an entire blue team Jirati on that E point. I was waiting for those stickies just to explode everybody, but it was that the demo man for MM actually died, and Silver Savages Invader, he actually died, excuse me, and he wasn't able to get those stickies down and just murder everybody. I mean, those mini-crit stickies are no joke.
They really aren't, that's for sure, and, you know, who are you going to call it for?
I'm going to have to go with SS on this attack.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright. You think they're going to go for E again?
I'm going for an around the world again. They're going all the way.
All right.
But
all
looks
the
like they want to commit. But we have MM sitting here on the defense. They have utility over on A. They have level 3 in the aggressive spot, just like before. And they have a heavy. They got Eerie Person sitting in the upper air, usually where a soldier sits. So definitely a weird choice of class to put up there. But we'll see if it works out for them.
Well, it was working out for Traylon earlier, who's doing quite a bit of damage and denying quite a bit of flank action going on there. And we still see a bit of dancing going on there. Looks like Joseph is watching the back spawn along with his friend Dahl, and both medics still 100%. Joe is down, he's the only casualty thus far at this moment. Sentry is in that aggressive spot that you so said that you enjoyed. And
I love it.
Ooh, Invader and Traylon down, as well as Palovly. That is really nice. Anticipated that, and that is some significant picks in favor of Memento Mori. Quite nice. Dahl taking down Godwash as well. And so they really need to, Silver Savages really needs to buck up and figure out where they want to push, because that hurt.
That was a nice little sticky trap from Giraffe. He's going to shut down the Silver Savages push very nicely. But it looks like they want to rotate through A and possibly go for a straight E push again. They have their Demo Man, and they have Godwash onto the point all over again. Looks like they're going to try to recreate what they did. But,
can we talk about
Scratchy? Yeah, Scratchy isn't going to have any of it. He has his level 3 in the connector, but the Silver Salvagers are going to Uber right into it. But Scratchy keeps it alive with that Wrangler and Rescue Ranger, so that is just going to completely shut down that E point. That specific location right there is so devastating to capping the E point, and they're not going to be able to cap until that goes down, which is going to require another Uber from Skies.
Mm-hmm. Traylon getting taken down right there by Joe once more. Actually, Angry Officer had a level 3 setup in that sort of B to E connector right there, but that got taken down really easily. And actually, the Sentry Gun does get taken down. Giraffe gets that. And a detonator pick from Joseph onto Godwash as we are having a push coming in. Oh, man. Both Invader and Skies and Lazy and Angry Officer and Traylon getting taken down here by the Memento Mori combo. That was really nice, really nice defense. And finally, Dahl taking down Jaxter as well in that soldier v soldier. Woo!
Some very, very good cleanup. Actually, Scratchy picked up his sentry gun. He just moved it over there. I don't think it went down, so he was just rotating it by hand. Yeah, but we have MM is just playing super aggressive, and this is how you win this map. Believe it or not, it's not playing passive. It's defending this B point for as much aggression as you possibly can. But it looks like Silver Savages wants to go over to E again. Eerie Person leading, spearheading this push, just shooting as many minigun bullets as he can possibly unload into the Silver Savages. And he's running around just doing a whole bunch of rotating. I don't know where he's going, but Traylon once again stuck at that forward spawn door, just destroying everybody. But oh, Skies is going to go down. Dahl picks up a Skies frag. So no more medic and no more heals for the Silver Savages team trying to cap this E point. Memento Mori is definitely going to be able to defend this with ease.
Mm-hmm. Godwash actually also getting taken down as well without those Twinkle Toes on point. It's going to be a lot harder to cap that E, and not to mention Invader got taken down as well by Dahl, so it's a pretty nice combo pick. Like you said, Soldier practically second Demo Man on this map, and I definitely see where you're coming from. And we do still have a really solid B defense, as oh my god, Skies once more, Giraffe hitting it for crap. Angry Officer down, Godwash down, Invader down, but not before. Oh my god, Plub was in position. Oh, I want it, please. Please, I want it. There he goes. Eerie Person gets taken down right there, and he paid his life for that frag, but I think it was worth it. Lazy gets caught out as well, and Traylon too. So that's nobody on B yet. A little bit of pressure on E. Jaxter gets finished off right there, and there's a mini being set up outside of that spawn. That's probably gonna get taken down very easily by Dahl, and yo, this is just a lot of back and forth.
Yeah, at this point, if you're Memento Mori, if you're MM, all you're going to want to do is just focus every single effort that you have onto the E cap. There's no way they're going to be able to around the world at a minute 20. So the only way that they're going to win is capping E. So you want to concentrate every single part of your fire onto defending this E point. And it looks like they know that, and they are doing that. So very, very good job. Giraffe. He's getting a lot of spam on this connector door, but Apple is gonna go ahead and pop his Uber onto a solo Invader. But I hear a short circuit going off, so yeah, that's no fun. That's no fun for Giraffe. Evader just cleaning him up. Evader's actually running that loose cannon. He is sitting on the door. 51 seconds left. This is definitely cappable. But we have Skis gonna go ahead and pop his Uber. Evader doing so much cleanup. We got Pyro Lazy coming in. Lazy getting a few frags with that Degreaser. And this might actually go into the hands of Silver Savages. They have to stack this point with more than times one. It's not going to cap at times one. Evader overextending. Oh, but it doesn't matter. He's gonna two-shot Duck Rider. Just gets double piped, so Evader leaving with his life alive, but he's still overextending. He's at 5 health. I'm gonna rotate over here. We got Pharaoh after. He's sitting up in the top, just shooting pot shots. Oh, gets a nice pick onto Bagel. Yeah, shooting shots right into that spawn door. This might go for Silver Savage, but at times one, it's not gonna matter. They have to stack more than that onto the point, and 5 seconds, it's not gonna happen.
I don't know, Momentum Warrior just really need to concentrate a little bit more right there. They're trying to pinch them off, but it wasn't quite happening. Skis was just staying alive as best as he could, and that was a really, really good cap by Silver Savages, that's for sure.
Oh, that was so close.
Mm-hmm.
Silver Savages didn't cap, they didn't make it.
What am I talking about?
Yeah, Momentum Warrior won that round off the time limit. Did they? Or am I crazy? Which one of us is crazy?
I'm pretty sure you're the crazy one.
Am I? Let me take a look.
The logs. You tell me. The logs never lie.
Yeah. So it's 1-1. Yeah, they did not cap that.
Okay, good.
Momentum Warrior won that off the time limit. Silver Savages needed more than times one for at least 20 seconds. They had times one on there, and it didn't cap it in time. And I think right at the very end there, they had times five and just a little sliver less to go, but it was too little too late, and they did not cap that. So we are at 1-1. We have one more round for tonight, ladies and gentlemen, so stay tuned. We are waiting until the next round starts. I'm going to go ahead and take a look at these new set of logs right here. Let me pull these up real quick.
Please do. For one, I'm glad that I'm the crazy one. I don't know what would have happened if my worldview got flipped upside down right there.
Whew. Holy cow, Giraffe.
Yeah.
Top frag on the server, 21 kills. He's at 560 DPM.
Oh my boy.
That's pretty good.
Yeah,
I mean, on a map like Steel, he didn't break 600, which is what I was hoping for. Actually, I have no clue, but he is at a grand total of 5 grand damage, so. Giraffe doing a lot of damage for his team. Jaxter, he's under there at second place for the Silver Savages at 17 frags, and Death Trolled is third over at 14 frags. So let me take a look at the overall total. We have MM with 81 frags to the Silver Savages 63, so it's nowhere near as big as it was before.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a very, very close round. Very good rotations coming out of the defending team. And unfortunately, Silver Savages just wasn't able to finish off that last cap, though.
Yeah, I'm actually really glad Memento Mori is turning it on. I was really worried that we'd have a 20-minute game on our hands. You know, what's the fun in that? If we're gonna frag, I want to see some awesome frags going on. And it's great that Joe managed to turn it on as well. He was getting some really nice picks throughout that second half.
Who is... Did they switch teams? I think they did.
Mm-hmm.
So we're probably going to have MM is going to defend this first point, I believe. My Highlander experience is correct. It should auto-switch the team. So we're going to have MM more than likely defending, and they're going to need a very, very good defense to be able to win this game. Both teams have seen each other's strats. They know what each team is going to do, and just the team that has the more experience is going to do it better. And at this point, I don't know. It's a 50-50. There's no team's better than another team right now, and it's all going to come to who makes the least amount of mistakes and who protects their medic better. Uber on this map is so good. There's only so many things that you can do without an Uber, and just being able to go through the chokes, being invulnerable, destroying sentry guns, it means so much. So,
absolutely. Especially in a map where spam is so tantamount. That's for sure. And here we are. We are starting right here. It looks like Silver Savages is once more on that offense, and Memento Mori is defending. And, you know, both of these teams, it really is up in the air. Both of them won their first steel match this season. I believe, 5-0 against the respective teams they played against, and so it's not like they're bad at the map, but I don't think most people enjoy playing this map all that much, and so if anything's really going to be instrumental in the downfall, it's that somebody, I feel like somebody's going to start tilting. I don't know, just, you know.
Since I like stats so much, I just keep looking back at them. On that last round, Apple actually only died one time to Skeez's 7 deaths. So, Skeez definitely needs to be protected a lot more if they're going to want to win this round. If Skeez dies 7 times again to Apple's 1, there's absolutely no way that Silver Savage is going to win. But we have SS, they're climbing over this A cliff, trying to take this A point for free. Skeez is actually coming out really, really early. He's up on that cliffside. I mean, a spy could be in any moment, and the Pyro is actually going to catch eyes on him. He's going to call them out. Looks like they might be wanting to go to this E point right away with their medic already out onto that A point.
Most definitely. We do have Palovly in position, Silver Savage's spy, so he's ready to try and do some sort of sapping action. Eerie Person is having none of it. And the A point does get capped over here, and it does look like Silver Savages, they're going to be doing that whole rotate thing. They're going to be trying to get in here. Traylon gets really lit, and actually Doll gets taken down by a very nice headshot by Pharaoh Affer. And so here we go. Sentry trying to get set up here, trying to lock down that spawn door once more. But it looks like, ooh, oh, that single pipe. Oh my gosh, Skeez is going to drop Angry Officer and Invader. Finally managed to move the Uber over onto Eerie Person. Oh,
I don't know where Geosis is. Oh, there he is, okay. I was gonna say, why don't they have Geosis over here just air blasting their combo away, but Scratchy's gonna pick up a frag and a Jax there. Actually, we have an Ubered Engineer under the Sentry Gun to try to defend this E point. Desperation Uber coming out of Apple. I'm not sure if he got forced or if he was just doing it just to save that level 3.
Oh, healing Palovly. Palovly's gonna come in here. It's not exactly gonna happen. The ruse was seen through. It was the other Uber forced out that second Uber. This sort of survival type deal going on. Skeez is approaching much more maneuver, and that one spawn door is still being locked down. Lazy is on that. Greasy's gonna be doing a lot of reflecting. Invader gets taken down by Doll, sort of slipping one through in the doors right there. And there is one on B trying to cap there. Lovely gets taken down by Doll as well. And so this is actually not a bad place to be defending. It's easy to rotate. It's easy to make stuff happen. Nobody's managed to get on E quite as much. The Uber does get taken out. Eerie Person is in there. Oh, goodbye, Invader. Uber demo into the pit.
Oh my
Skeez
god.
Gonna just do a skate.
Did you see Skeez's surf? He just surfed off of that. That was an amazing surf. Oh, Skeez, he's actually gonna get air blasted again.
No.
And his surfing skills aren't going to allow him to live. So that was awesome. Geosis being in a very, very good position, which is where I wanted him before, but I mean, I guess he wanted to flog something. So good on you, Geosis. Good job.
There's nothing wrong with having a little bit of fun and running from Justinator and making everybody else angry. Eerie Person picking up a frag onto Palovly, who's not been having too much luck so far, but we'll see if he can turn it on a little bit later. And we do see a little more pressure from the Silver Savages onto B, and yo, they need to get back to where they were that first round, that really measured rotation that they had going between E and B and E and B, and make something happen.
Yeah, the general rule is like, if you can try once to do an E push, but after that it's never gonna work again. And like, then you just need to go around the world or do an ABE. But we have Apple popping his Uber, just cleaning up all these easy frags. Like, this is just no contest for MM right now. Traylon goes down, Lazy goes down. So that is almost, that is a full combo wipe actually for SS. And they need to stop going for E. It's not gonna work. MM knows that you're doing it, and MM is going to rotate. You have to muscle yourself into E, and you have to go around the world, or you have to do an A cap, and you have to go fast. You have absolutely no time to waste.
Absolutely. Scratchy did have a pretty nice sentry in position, but probably took that down, but not before he got taken down as well. Giraffe in position with his pyro as well. What am I talking about? I'm saying as well too many times, and B got capped, and so we're seeing more of a C rotation going on here as Traylon, his combo are going to be moving in here. Invader throwing down stickies. Palovly, I just see his name in the kill feed a whole lot, and it looks like Apple's going to be caught up. Invader jumped in, Jaxter jumped in as well. Apple down, Scratchy down, Doll down, Yuri person as well. So is Saya. That is going to be just Joe over here on the C point. And looks like Silver Savages was taking our advice and practically wiped Memento Mori, except for Bagel, who can't really do too much on this point.
Almost like I talked to them and I was like, yo, you gotta go do this. And then they did it. Oh, I'm a genius. But we have MM. They are trying to set up what they can. They just got a bunch of respawns, and they are rotating over to that DA connector over by the IT, is usually what people call it. But it doesn't look like Silver Savages even wants to cap that C point. Yeah, they want to go straight over to E and just muscle this cap. And I mean, they should at least cap C. It affects the spawns, it affects the whole map. But Ski is gonna go down to a pick from Scratchy's mini sentry, not something you see every day. Bad positioning from Ski's, or extreme aggression from Scratchy, I'm not sure which. But we have Invader just shooting this iron bomber over into the connector. He is actually alone, so he's gonna go down after picking up a nice frag onto Geosis.
Yo, Lazy is my hero right now. Actually, Palovly's my hero because he just took down Giraffe, but Lazy was my hero, standing on that point, reflecting every single sticky being thrown at him, and that is now times four on the point as that. There we go. There's the cap. 5 minutes, 39 seconds, finally. Yo, Jaxter doing a really good job there. He was just all over the place that round.
Yeah, that was good. I mean, these 5.5 minute caps, like, they're very good times. Don't get me wrong, but they're easily beatable. Like, they're nothing like super substantial, like a 3.5, a 4 minute time. 5.5 minutes, definitely still very good. But MM, they're gonna be able to cap this. And with how they've been playing, both teams have been playing, it's anybody's game, but I'm gonna have to go and say that MM is gonna take this one.
Oh, a bit of an upset.
Yeah. What are you thinking? What you got?
You know what? I want to believe. I want to throw it out to MM as well. I believe they're fifth in the rankings right now, while Silver Savages is substantially higher than that. And so, you know, I would be happy to see a bit of a black sheep thing going on right here.
I was looking at a Silver Savages roll, but yeah. Memento Mori, even with the little practice they've had, they've brought out their A game, and they're bringing quite a show. But we do have MM. They are flooding these the 8 gates, trying to take the point as fast as they can. The crit stickies get spot out, so those aren't going to do absolutely anything at all. And we have a giraffe shutting down that A spawn door. It looks like he's going to run back and rotate over the B with his combo.
Oh my god, did you see that game of Ring Around the Rosie between Jaxter and Joe?
I swear he was
looking for that spy for an hour, and Joe's sitting there with like 5 health. Oh god, please. And here we go. A is capped. It looks like B is what is gonna be happening. It looks like what people. Ooh, Pharaoh, after getting a nice headshot onto Giraffe, just managed to peek. But that isn't gonna happen anytime soon. Scratchy gets taken down by Palovly as well. And we do have a level 3 that was Angry Officer overlooking that entrance, making sure that nothing really gets in there. And Jaxter is actually pretty aggressive right here. Joseph says no, gets that point blank reflect practically, and takes him down. Very nicely. Oh my god, I love Reflex. They're just pretty great. Uber gets popped out, Apple with Giraffe, trying to throw some stuff out onto the sentry. Joe jumps down and saps it as well. Traylon down as well. Invader down as well. I'm just saying as well, that is just my word for this cap, I suppose. And that is going to be a really nice push by Memento Mori, and that is a B cap.
That entire cap was all on the shoulders of Death. He cleaned up a sentry gun, a heavy, and I think he got another frag. I'm not quite sure who it was, but with those 3 picks and that sentry gun alone, that B cap was all on his shoulders, so very good job. We have MM trying to push his connector. Looks like they want to rotate over to, you're going to guess it? Not Death Hallway, but Death Gate. But it looks like they are going to ignore that, and they are going to want to push through this hallway right into a sticky trap of Invader. So let's see if they notice that. Hopefully they don't all explode. But Eerie Person kind of tank that with the Fist of Steel, but he gets picked by Pharaoh after, so we have Apple. He's in a very, very bad position right now. He's easily spammable. He needs to move, or else Skies is just going to Uber on him and force his Uber in a very I can't think of the word, just a place he doesn't want to pop his Uber, I'm sorry, if you will.
It's okay, inopportune place. Joseph takes the dregs of that Uber by Apple, and we do have a push onto C right here. Skies getting taken down by Bagel, gets a really nice headshot into him. Traylon down, Invader down. I'm just seeing a lot of Kill him for the fake. Godwash falls into the pit. GG. And Memento Mori is going to be able to, it looks like, take these points in rapid succession. They have about 3 minutes on the clock. I think they could likely make it to D, to E, to D, and then to E if nothing too awful and terrible happens. And it looks like they're going to be flooding through that connector, getting in onto D. The Silver Savages combo is going to be there to meet them. Palubli gets taken down, Godwash down once more. Syath is, trying to do that flank thing. Invader's gonna say absolutely not to him, however. And we're gonna have a stack on D from Memento Mori.
So, just watch an Angry Officer. He does have a level 3 onto this E point, but he's actually, like, locked himself into this upper area. Mm-hmm. He has his dispenser, like, blocking the doorway to stop spies, but he's also locked in there. He's just easily gonna get spammed out. Absolutely no contest from Giraffe. And Treylon, they're just gonna clean him up, so that is engineered down. That is a free E point, and the MM squad.
Oh my god.
we have a melee battle coming out over here.
Oh,
that was Apple and Farlaffer just having a melee battle. But MM is probably gonna clean up this point.
A lovely butterknife Giraffe there in the aftermath of that, and Ski's gonna have that 100% Uber to defend with. But Syath's gonna be sort of dancing around on this point here, trying to get that times 2. Memento Mori is trying to jockey into position as well, moving from that A to E, and it looks like Apple's gonna be taking this team in here. And here we go! Uber gets popped out, Ski's gets taken down to about 40 health, and Syath gets taken down by Angry Officer Sentry. Palovly also down in the carnage, but that was a pretty good backup. It looks like a rotation from Memento Mori, so that Uber didn't really get too many frags, and so Silver Savages is going to be set up in this sort of IT area and waiting for the next aggression.
Yeah, Apple, he's at 95%. MM has one chance at this. They have to get bodies on the point, and they have to frag. So they have to do a combination of both. It looks like Apple and Geosis and Giraffe, so many G's just going in here, cleaning up a lot of frags. And they got the frag, but now they need to cap. Times 3 on the point, that might actually be enough. But they are going to want to rotate their combo over into the upper area so they can defend from the waves of respawns. Times 4, they're almost halfway there, so it's going to be super close, but they need to get bodies onto this point to cap.
30 seconds.
I just saw a Jirati go on. Oh
Ski's
my god,
Skis
actually died with 95% Uber. Oh my gosh, this is so close. If Skis had that Uber, so many fries going into the hands of MM. Silver Savage is almost completely wiped, only Treeline alive. And we have MM actually going to win this game. Shoutouts to the underdogs. Oh my gosh.
Oh my god. Just before Joe got that baller pick onto Skis, I get a Steam message from him that says, "Did I do you proud?" Yes. Yes, you did do me very proud. That was beautiful.
Oh my god. What an ending.
Right? Like 20, 25, 28 seconds left on the clock? Very, very nice, and good show out by both of the teams.
Woo! Well, that was an awesome game, and I just got linked logs, and I know I keep talking about them, but I mean, the logs don't lie. If you look at this real quick, Skis actually died double times as Apple. Skis is 6 to Apple's 3, so I'm gonna have to say that Apple having a very good game, and Apple's combo protecting him. He only died a handful of times. I mean, I can think of died once, died 3 times. I'm not sure on the first round, but very, very good protection. And those Ubers that he was popping were so good. And definitely the combo of MM won them this game, hands down.
Oh, for sure. Honestly, it was just Treylon and Invader were going down far too much. There wasn't really a way to bounce back after that without those heavy classes in play. And I mean, Jaxter was trying to do all that he could. He was top fragging in the server, 14 frags, but you can't really make up for the rest of your heavy classes being unable to follow up on that. So, yo, that is a win for Memento Mori. Woo!
That was a fun game. And this Steel's growing on me. I used to hate it, but over the years, I've definitely come to enjoy it after I've like thoroughly learned the map. And it's a lot of fun. Very fun to cast, very fun to play, very fun to watch. Especially when you get close games like these, that was something else. It's the closest game I've seen in a long, long while.
Mm-hmm. And, so before we go, you have any shout-outs, Mario?
Shout-outs to Kitty Kicker, one of the original DK members. Hopefully you're watching, buddy. Nah, that's all I got.
Nice, nice. Well, before we go, just want to remind you, shirts down there underneath the video player. You know, put people's favorite designs on your body, support your favorite caster, support your favorite producer, all that jazz. Big thanks for Dashner for doing a wonderful job on camera, as always. Of course, we can't expect anything else from him. And shoutouts to both teams for playing, being pretty cooperative, and showing us some great video games tonight. Thanks for tuning in, everyone.